Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to demonstrate about the digital multimeter with USB interface. So this is our digital multimeter which has the USB interface connections and different measurement capacity on different ranges. The order code for this digital multimeter is 17702. You can query and check the specs about this multimeter using this order code. So this is the complete multimeter in which we are providing the test probes to test leads to test the any component and other supplies and different values in the multimeter. This is the USB interface cable with this and a CD in which all the documents and drivers and softwares are provided for the data logging of the all parameters which is measured by this meter. So these are the different values. The meter is a steady frame meter in which this is the sliding guard for the jacks provided on the front panel, and this guard covers the jacks on HFE value for transistors, and when you want to use, pull up the jack, and when you want do not use this meter, pull down the jack. This will cover the jacks from dust and other particle to be inserted. Now this meter comes with the rubber frame with the K2 insulation capacities, and this is the USB port of this multimeter by which you can connect the USB cable to any PC interface, and PC interface details and describes all the requirement of the PC and the other systems and the software OS are given in the user manual. You can read out all the specification to install the software and how to work with the software on this multimeter. So this is a meter in which the LCD screen is provided, and these are the different values which can be measured. The voltage in DC, AC, dBm's and microampere current, mu ampere current in AC and DC as well, 4 milliampere current in AC and DC as well, resistance, capacitance for continuity testing and diode testing, also the hertz and the logic of any of the value you can check with this, and HFE value of the transistors, and these are the two off points of this transistor, so you can turn the dials on different value you want to measure. This is the select button in which the upper value should be selected when you change the value like this. So right now this is at the voltage, and when you press the select value, this turns the measurement range to the dBm's. Similarly, this is on the DC right now, and when we turn the value to select, this will be going to the AC value for measurement. So we will start with measurement of voltage. So in this you can measure the DC voltage, and if you see the auto signal on the LCD screen, the range will be automatically shifted whatever voltage range you measure with this. So if you want to change the range manually, this will change the range in light. Right now this is showing that it is in millivolts, and when we press this to change the range, this is now in the volts. So this is how you change the range by selecting range with this range button. For relative measurements, you can press this relative parameter. This will relate the measurement with different values where you want to relative the value with other measurements. Minimum maximum for also provided to capture the minimum maximum value while measurement of any of the value of instance. So this will give you and shows the only when you set this to the minimum, this will show you the maximum value, and when you set this to the minimum value, whatever value you want to measure, you can set the minimum maximum value as per the requirement. And this is the hold button to hold the steady reading measurements, and hertz, duty and width terminal are required. This button is required in logic and different value measurement for logical purpose. Now we start measuring the value. This is the test probes with this. This is our improper insulated cover. So you have to remove these caps from the test points, and from the jack inserting point, you have to remove the caps as well to insert the jacks. And to measure the value, these test probes are required, and you can connect the test probes on this by removing this slide guard. So At this terminal, you can measure the voltage milliampere and resistance up to 1 kilovolt in DC, similarly 750 volts in AC and 400 milliamperes maximum for different milliampere ranges. And this is the common terminal, and this is the current terminal in which the DC-AC current can be measured, but up to 10 ampere the fuse is inserted inside, which will provide the safety for the high overcurrents. So right now I have inserted both the test probe. Here I have a 9 volt battery to measurement for DC value or DC voltage. So I will connect the test probe on positive and negative, and this is showing the value in relative. So I will off the meter again and start this, and this is showing in auto mode the 9.2 volts. To change the range, you can change the range. So this is showing 9.2 volts. This is 9 volt in the resolution changes, and in the millivolt, this is 9.24 volts for the resolution. So this is the value of a battery where you can measure. For AC measurement, you can use these probes to any AC socket or any other AC terminal to measurement the AC values. So we will insert these probes in a AC socket. Now, as you can see, in the AC socket I have inserted the black probe, and for the phase we will insert the phase probe, and this is automatically detecting the AC voltage, which is 227 AC for this socket, so by which you can measure this different AC voltages accordingly. For measurement of current at different ranges, you have to select the dial on mu ampere and ampere range, and similarly you have to change this probe on ampere section as well. This will connect and select the automatic range of the value whatever you want to measure. But right now we do not have any component to measure the current, so you have to connect this meter in series with any of the AC equipment which you want to measure the current for AC or DC measurement of current, for mu ampere and for milliampere as well. We move on to the resistance value. So as I move on to the resistance value, this is showing the fault because I have connected the test probe on the 10 ampere. So this is showing me signal that I have to change the probe to the resistance jack. So now I have inserted the probe in the resistance jack. So for measuring the resistance, I have some resistance component here. So by seeing the value of this resistance by color code, this should be at 15k, and this is around 15 kilo ohms, which is measurement of this meter is correct, and this should be the 220 ohm resistance. So this is approx 217 218 ohms in the resistance meter on the LCD screen we are seeing. So this is how we measure the resistance value. Now for capacitance with the resistance value, so we will change the mode to by select. So we'll press the select button. This is now for measurement of capacitors. So this is a 1 microfarad capacitor over here. So you can touch the both probes, and this is showing approx 1 microfarad in the meter, 0.997 microfarad for this capacitance. So this is also how we measure the capacitance value with this. Now for diode testing, you can turn this to the diode. Right now this is showing that the continuity is open because both the terminals are open, and when we touch the terminal, this is showing that the terminals are short. So this is how we check the continuity on front. So indication are also provided with the beep as well. For diode testing of any diode value, we will change the value to select, and this is now at the diode testing. On the LCD you can see the indication, and for testing the diode, connect the positive to the positive of diode and negative to the negative of the diode, and this is showing the diode drops in voltage. This is 0.524 volt for this diode. Now for measurement of logic here, so logic value, so we will change this value to the select, and this is showing the low right now on the meter. Now with this battery, approx value of 5 volts or more than 5 volts will seen with this. So when we connect any value positively, so this will give us the logic high. So this is now giving us the logic high, and as I remove the probe from this, this is giving us the low value. So you can check the logic values or logic states as well with this meter. For measurement of frequency of AC, so we will connect this to the AC socket. Now we will measure the HFE value of transistor. For this, remove the test probes, slide down the sliding guard, and you can test the any of the transistor on these terminals. So place the emitter base and collector on proper position as described in the HFE panel, and turn this dial to the HFE. So as I connect this on the HFE mode, this is showing that the 306 is the HFE value of this transistor, and you remove the transistor. Similarly for other transistor, properly insert the transistors all three terminal. So this is the HFE value of this transistor as well. Now we'll remove the transistor, and this is, or for off the meter, to off the meter, you can turn the dial to the off position. So this is all about this meter, digital multimeter. For communicating it with the PC, the requirements of the PC are described in the user manual. For the computer requirements are provided. This is the software and hardware requirements and the description, and the software uses, how to use the software for data logging and measurements are also described in the user manual as well. So you can easily use this software to collecting the all data by this multimeter. So this is for all about with this meter. For any queries while working with this meter, you can contact 2 Tesca Technologies Private Limited for any kind of support. Thank you.